Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Guys, it is early spring, late winter. We're here at the mid-February. We're out here at the honey hole. I hadn't been out here for about a month or so. Just kind of come out here and check, see what the fish are doing. I'm going to bet they're probably moving up shallow, getting ready to make beds and things. I fished a tournament last weekend over on Bob Sandlin, and water temperature was about 54 degrees on the big lake. So I'm betting it's 54, 55 out here, and that's usually about the time we start seeing those little buck bass move up. So if you guys want to hang in there today, we're going to go out here and check them out. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation for some fishing right here at the Honey Hole in Point, Texas. Alright guys, I'm down here at the Honey Hole. Today I'm going to be throwing two or three different lures. I brought with me a little frog here. I know it's probably a little early for frog season, but never know, just want to be prepared. The other bait I brought is a red jackhammer, and I put a little, it's like a fluke, but it's like a flat-tailed fluke trailer on there. We're going to try that. And another good bait I think will work is I'm going to throw this little fluke right here. I'm going to use it just with a little nose hook, circle, weedless hook, because like I said, we're going to be getting up in the shallows here, seeing if we can find these fish. So we're going to walk out here. Now, I'm going to be real honest with you. I'm a little fat, a little out of shape. I'm going to have to walk because we've had about 24 inches of rain here in the last month and a half. So the ground's a little soft. And I don't want to tear up my landowner's property. He's kind enough to let me come out here and fish. So I'm going to get this stuff gathered up. But if I'm huffing and puffing, y'all just have to forgive me. Stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. All right, guys, we're down here at the Honey Hole. Told you I was going to throw two or three different baits. I'm throwing it on an underspin. Don't normally throw some of those baits on an underspin, but this underspin has a 25-pound braid on it. You gotta watch where you step down here. There's fire ants there where I'll be out here dancing again. So y'all hang tight. Let's see what we can do. I'm throwing a little wacky worm just because that's what I had tied on. It's a wacky worm. It's in a watermelon red. I'm just gonna pitch it around some of these shallow grass flats up here. Got a lot of that old slimy pond moss everywhere up here. See what we can do with it. Had a cold front blow through here last night. At temperature yesterday was about 74, 75 degrees. That ought to be a good spot right there. Sorry about the wind, guys. I'm facing right into it. See if we can find some of them up here shallow. Up, oh, there's a little bump right there. He liked it. Just didn't commit. I didn't think he did, but he did. He committed and he was headed to deep water. He liked that old wacky worm. He said, let me try a little bit of that. I brought my pliers today because I figured it's either going to be biting short or biting deep. He barely tapped that thing. Let's see if I can get it out of there. Look at there. He was just barely hooked, y'all. Anyway, little old buck bass right there, about a pound. He liked that wacky worm. He didn't even knock the grass guard off of it. He just picked it up and headed toward deep water with it. I barely felt him tap that thing. Looks like Mr. Wobble's got a big old brush pile over there. Might ought to see if I can't get my little John boat out here and dig some of that out of there and take it down here and put it out in a few places. Like I said, I ain't been down here in about a month. I just figure that water temperature, like it is at the lake, that this little old pond would warm up a little quicker. And this is the end they usually do all the spawning on down here. See how hungry they are after that little front we had. See what we can come up with. Like I was saying, we got a little ditch over here that it's usually pretty good. It comes in. Golly, did y'all see that? That thing nearly jerked it out of my hand. I'm gonna have to quit talking and start fishing. I got it wrapped up around y'all, me, and let's give him another chance at it. It just got heavy all of a sudden. Dadgum, I'm gonna have to tighten my drag up now. All right, Mr. Fish, you're gonna have to cough right now. You're making me look like an amateur. I got him that time. He's either hung in some bushes, or that's a little better fish than I thought it was. That's a little better fish than I thought it was, but I'll take that. But he also took my wacky worm. That's about a 2.5 pounder.
Get out one of these red. Did I bring one of them? Heck no, I sure didn't. I failed y'all on that. I just brought the one. Let's get out one of these nose hook flukes. I think we'll do good on it. You guys can see right there, I'm just gonna hook that thing right through the nose. And I'm hooking it with a belly down, hook point up. We'll see what we can do with that right there, guys. That's a pretty nice little fish.
They like to lay down there in that ditch. A little deeper over there. Just gonna kind of let that thing fall. Just twitch it a little bit. That one actually hit that wacky worm on the fall. I had a Senko on there, had it wacky rigged. But that's what I had on this pole. I just happened to start throwing it. There's one on that little old fluke there. Well, started out that way anyway. So it looks like the fluke might work for us. Let's see. I think if I was a fish, that's where I'd be, right along the edge. Guys, I think we got one here. Yep. Man, I'm telling you what, guys, I'm just barely getting these suckers hooked. They are being super finicky.
But we got another one there to commit for us. So, like I said, he ain't a giant, but he will do. Get the stink on you anyway. Y'all ever like just come out somewhere and fish a little bit and get the stink on you? I do. Get me wrong, I like to catch them big ones too, but I like to get out here and just get a little pond fish smell on me every once in a while. My wife, she always appreciates when I wipe all this fish, moss, and junk on my britches. Y'all say a little prayer for her. No, not because she's married to me, but I mean, you can always do that, but just because she's been feeling under the weather here for the last couple months and she hasn't really been able to fish. She's been having a lot of problems with her wrist and stuff. So anyway, let's scoot on down. All right, guys, let's see if we can't pitch out here. See if we can't pull one off these weed lines out here. Wish I'd have been a little to the left and hit that little channel over there. We can always make another cast though. Always make another cast. All right. Looks like a good spot to pick up fish. Guys, if you're watching this video and you're a member of Texas Bass Holes, drop your name down there in the comments. And what I'm gonna do is I had told you guys about a little free offer to come down here and fish at the Honey Hole. So if you're in Texas Bass Holes, drop your name in the comments, and I'm gonna let a few people get their name in there, and then I'm going to do a drawing for a free day of fishing down here at the Honey Hole with me. And if you're not a member of Texas Bass Holes, man, it's one of the fastest growing fishing pages right now on Facebook. We'll come down here, go ahead and join that, Texas Bass Holes. Drop your name in the comments, because I will be checking. Anyway, we'll come down here and we'll catch us a bunch of these little fun fish, and I'll cook you guys lunch. How's that sound? Let's see what this does for us. I'll tell you what, guys, we're going to do. We're gonna reel this dude in and take it off. We're gonna put that orange chatterbait on. Walk around, see what we can't do with that. All right, guys, I got this orange chatterbait tied on. I've got a feeling, probably gonna wanna short strike it a lot. I got this big old long trailer on there. But we'll see. If they do, we'll take it off and try again. But I don't normally throw a chatterbait on an underspin rod. I got one right there. I thought I had a bunch of moss on there. He just barely bumped that thing. Another little old buck bass. He said he'd get in there and get him a little bit of that. I was hoping we'd get one of them big females that's staging up. He hit that thing wholeheartedly. Must have thought it was a crawfish. And you throw this thing halfway across the pond. I got that frog in my pocket too. Oh, looky there. That in there was ready for it. He done put it on the chatterbait. Boy, I mean, I want you guys to look right there. I mean, I had that sucker just barely hooked. Another little buck. We'll throw this another time or two. Across top of that water like that. They seem to be up shallow. Good looking stuff over here behind. Oh yeah, there's a good one. A little better fish there, boys. I'm literally throwing this thing right now in about 6 inches of water. Man, that thing just clatters when it comes through there, under the water. Sounds so good. We might just need to keep on keeping on with what we got going on. Cause this little red chatterbait seems to be doing a pretty good job. I believe there's fish on the nest over there. Did y'all see that fish dart off that, and went out there and turned around and came back? Man, I just can't quit casting, guys. It's just unbelievable. I figured that'd be biting a little slower on smaller stuff out here today, but woo-wee, I believe we just spooked one off right there. Looked like that might have been a big old good one. I'm trying to go slow enough that I don't get it tangled up, but oh, there went one right there, guys. He said, "Here, get up in here. Get up in here, give me some of that right there." I said, "I like the way that looks." Boy, he's a feisty little buck. Man. Well, I'm telling you what, that was right on the bank right there. Don't get no bankier than that. There's another one, guys. We might have done found the juice for the day. Yes, sir? Go back and tell your mama we want to see her. We might have found the juice for the day. All right, we're on the other side of that little slough. I got to watch the time because my little boy's birthday party today. He's 13. I sure don't want to miss that. Hey guys, thanks for joining the channel today. I appreciate you. Hope you guys enjoyed our content. Tomorrow's Trevor's birthday. He'll be 13, as I've mentioned a couple times in the video. I'm gonna head on out of here and go get some of my mom's homemade beef stew, because that's what she cooked Trevor for birthday supper, because that's what that boy likes. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the content. Don't ever give up. Just keep grinding, and eventually you'll find the juice. You seen that today, I think. We caught a few here and a few there. Done most of our damage on the chatterbait. But guys, until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish all of you tight lines.